We're here again for game two of day three of the WFTDA East Region Playoffs of the Dewburns Arena in Baltimore, Maryland, as we're going to see Boston Massacre take on the Dutchland All-Stars. I'm Laydot Lyle alongside Kevin Up, and what an exciting bout we have here in day three.
That's right. This is actually a rematch of a bout that took place at ECDX earlier this year in Philadelphia. Boston emerged victorious 142-104 over Dutchland at the time.
Wow.
And here's how they got here so far in this tournament. On Friday night, Boston suffered a loss to Charm City, the number three seed in the East, 191-88. On Saturday morning, they did have a victory over Maine, 177-69, and then a loss to London, the number 10 seed, 142-95, although that number 10 seed is a bit deceiving, as people just didn't really know a whole lot about London, and they've really come in here and proven that they are a force to be reckoned with.
London's been amazing, showing they definitely belong in the WFTDA Big Five. Dutchland had a win over Maine on day one, 194-117, a controversial forfeit. We may talk about that a little bit later against Gotham. And then a loss to Montreal yesterday, 225-124. We're in jam one as V Diva is the lead jammer for Dutchland.
That's right, and Claire DeWay is out behind her for Boston, number 1984. V Diva, nice leap of the apex going around turn one, keeping her balance.
Both of these jammers are just extremely skilled. V Diva through the pack with four. But it looks like Claire DeWay picks up four of her own. It's a wash so far.
That's right, two of the fastest skaters in the WFTDA right there. Both of them on the U.S. Women's World Cup team this year. Looks like two additional points picked up by Dutchland there. So a two-point lead to start off.
Both teams cracked their eggs right out of the first jam, but the advantage to Dutchland. And if you are watching on WFTDA.com on your regular stream, upgrade to the high definition stream now. It's gorgeous. We're watching it right here live. You'll be glad you did.
We had a penalty free first jam there, so we still have four blockers against four blockers in the pack right now. That is Sugar Hits for Boston jamming. She's trying to get around the outside now on the inside there.
Skid Ho.
That's right. Skid Ho, number 18 for Dutchland. And Sugar Hits is lead jammer. First lead jammer of the bout for Boston.
Skid Ho having some difficulty breaking through the pack. Goes to the outside at turn one. Tries to make it past Shatterly and Shank and does so. Both girls on the scoring run.
That's right. Sugar Hits, though, all the way through on her first pass, not wasting any time. Calling off the jam for four quick points for Boston, who has regained the lead.
0 points for Dutchland.
That's right. So both jams we've seen so far, both pretty fast-paced, cleanly played jams, although I'm sure some minor penalties have been picked up, so we'll probably start seeing some trips to the penalty box soon. But for now, it's empty.
Both of these teams with just single wins here in this tournament, but both of their wins were very decisive. There was no close wins here. In fact, there hasn't been but really one close game this entire tournament anyway.
That's right. That was Carolina versus Montreal yesterday. An unbelievable bout. And we've got Lil Payne, number 451 degrees for Boston on the track.
And Nash Villain for Dutchland.
Lil Payne at the front of the pack. She's got two Dutchland blockers to get past. She's trying to push past some nice blocking, though, by Dutchland.
Nash Villain looking to squeeze past a three wall in the back, but it is Lil Payne getting some help from LCD in the front.
There's sort of two fronts here. There's a front wall and a back wall here. Back wall is Boston. Front wall is Dutchland right now. Lil Payne finally breaking through. Looks like she was awarded lead jammer. Got her hips past Bella Leblowski. Leblowski. And Lil Payne just calls off the jam there as Nash Villain had actually escaped from the pack completely.
First double goose egg jam of the bout. And we may see a lot of that here, Kevin, as these teams are we've seen more work in the pack than we have from the jammers. A lot of jostling around and a lot to prove here as one of these teams is going to even out their score and the other one is going to go home with a 3-1 record, or a 1-3 record, excuse me.
That's right. I'm sure both these teams really do want to go home with that 2-2 record right now and to earn the seventh seed going into the offseason. and Clarity Way, the jammer for Boston. She's met with a wall of Dutchland at the front. Oh, she sneaks out, though, on the inside, keeping her balance.
Wow.
Lee Jammer.
White Thrash looking to make her initial pass on the outside of the front straightaway and does so. Both girls on a scoring run.
That's right. She snuck by the pivot. Lady Shatterly there at the front. There's some fierce blocking here. There's a blocking out-of-bounds penalty on Bumpus. And four quick points picked up by Claire D. Way, extending their lead to 6 points.
Boston so far early on getting little tidbits of advantage that are paying off, bringing us to 12-6 in the score.
And that is V. Diva over there on the Dr. Hauschka jam line for Dutchland. And there is a jammer for Boston as well. Our view of her. Oh, that is Sugar Hits. There, okay. Jammer for Boston. They should just all get down so we can see easier.
Maybe if both teams do a mass proposal every time on the jam, we could see a very slow start.
That's right. There's Anorexia trying to meet V Diva at the back. V Diva into the back of Shark Week. Very and stumbling there a little bit.
Diva on the outside. Looks to the inside. Neither girl with the advantage, but now it's Sugar Hits through the middle of the front straightaway. She's the lead jammer.
There she goes. And V Diva, the very fast V Diva, out behind her about maybe 15, 20 feet or so.
Sugar Hits.
Sugar Hits going to try and get one or two and call it off. And she did. She opened herself up for that one.
Treasure chest dropping Sugar Hits down to the ground as she calls off the jam.
Wow, Sugar Hits shaking up a little bit. Looks like she's going to be just fine, though.
That was a brutal hit.
It sure was, although, you know, sometimes when those jammers put their hands up to let the jam ref know that they're about to call off the jam, they really do sort of open up their body a little more to those big hits.
Oftentimes, they even let down their guard standing up.
Yep, that's right. A lot more upright. Sugar Hits already a very upright skater, and so that opened up even more. Anyways, we've got Lo Payne, the jammer, on the line for Boston.
And Skid Ho for Dutchland. Little Payne down.
She got lead jammer, though, it looks like.
She did.
That's right. She passed her hips once again. This is the second jam, I think, in a row from Lo Payne that we've seen her emerge just barely out of the pack and get lead jammer and then get sucked back in. But nonetheless, no damage for Boston there.
This bout brought to you in part by Warrior Dash. Are you a warrior? Check them out, warriordash.com, and you can be a warrior too.
Who doesn't want to be a warrior? Claire Duway is definitely a warrior, and she is jamming on the line for Boston.
And Nashville for Dutchland. Nashville with a hop on the inside of turn two.
That's right. Although it didn't get her any progress, she is stuck at the hack back there. And Clarity Way has emerged as a lead jammer. Nashville trying to get by Lois Carmen Dominator. And she got just one or two of her wheels out of bounds. That's enough for a major track cut.
Oh, wow. First power jam given up.
And Claire DeWay trying to do the Super Mario there, getting down low, trying to sneak under, get some coins. Paying the price, though. Claire DeWay known for her very low skating.
Claire DeWay has had just extremely impressive lateral movement through the pack. Very fast, unbelievably agile. It shows why she's on Team USA.
Right now, Boston has trapped Twisted Scissors in the back. Claire DeWay is sort of on her own now. Lois Carmen Dominator recognizing she's got to get up there and help Claire DeWay. But Claire, oh my goodness, this is fierce right now.
Wow.
Good penalty kill right now for Dutchland.
Claire DeWay just desperately trying to make it past a three wall.
Ginger Kid, all Ginger Kid right there, knocking out Hillbilly Hellcat. That's number 43, Ginger Kid with the red helmet for Boston.
Grand slam for Claire DeWay. And that might be the first grand slam of the bout.
I think it was. And here comes Claire. It looks like she picked up a minor back block there, although she has yielded and is repassing. Should be eligible for the points. And she's just about out past Jolene Jawbreaker here, number three for Dutchland. And there she goes. She has emerged. And five more points for Claire DeWay.
Double digit so far. As Claire DeWay taking full advantage of the power jam while it was in place. It's over now, and Nashville has made her initial pass.
Yeah, she has a Claire DeWay getting another pass in here as time is expiring on the jam. Wow, one additional pass of 5 points. Was that about, it looks like a 15-0 jam there for Boston, taking advantage of the power jam.
A natural power grand slam there. And the most points scored in any one jam with Milk Maiden, blocker for Dutchland, being sent to the penalty box right at the end of that jam. And a mass proposal being put down by Boston.
A mass proposal. I like that.
A mass proposal, yes.
Wow. Hey, I think we've got out there Renegade Raven jamming right now. That looks like Crash Daly.
It is.
I believe Providence, the referee there.
And Sugar Hits jamming for Boston.
Sugar Hits knocking her pivot out of the way. Lady Shatterly just kind of throwing her into 1-2-3-4 rum and choke there. And Sugar Hits is the lead jammer for Boston, who's taking early control of this bout. That's Etta Mames, the big hitter at the back there, taking a swing at Renegade Raven, who's trying to squeeze through the back wall of Boston. 1987 Shark Week taking a hit at Renegade Raven as well. And we've got a major track cut being called on Renegade Raven. So back-to-back power jams here for Boston.
That is not going to add up good for Dutchland at all. If they keep giving up power jams, it's going to be an easy night, or morning, actually, for Boston.
And Sugar Hits able to pick up the five-point grand slam here. That was a very unusual spot where Renegade Raven picked up that track cut. It was on the actually outside around turns 3 and 4. You don't usually see track cuts around there.
No, you don't.
And here comes Sugar Hits again on another scoring pass.
Sugar Hits avoiding a down skater, trying to find her way past
Hillbilly Hellcat there. Yeah, and Hillbilly Hellcat, Sugar Hits got a track cut there, but it was just a minor track cut. So very fortunate that there was another Dutchland blocker in front of Hillbilly Hellcat there, just barely in front.
It's sometimes the most minute things that makes the big difference here, and that big difference translated into another 5 points as we see her post up a third for 15 so far.
Shark Week had a nice clear out offensive block of Twisted Scissors right there.
Power jam did end before the jam ended. And Boston increases their lead to a 42-point spread.
And yes, they have. Although, you know, as if you've been watching this whole bout, that's kind of a deceptive score. Really, two big power jams accounts for almost that entire lead. Almost. Not all of it. Not discrediting you guys, Boston. And that's V Diva out there, the jammer for Dutchland. And they're going to need trying to put out their top jammer here to try and get some momentum back on their side.
Looks like Little Pain going to be jamming for Boston.
And we've got a little time out here on the track, so we'll let you know that one of the sponsors of the WFTDA Championships is Elemental Technologies, the world's most powerful video processing solutions, Elemental Technologies.
Also thanks to Wicked Skatewear, whether you're on or off the track, time to get wicked.
And so, as you were saying before, there was that sort of controversial situation that came up on, was that Friday?
It was. Right? Dutchland decided they had a bout that, because they won the first game, they were going to go up against the historically dominant Gotham, and they decided to forfeit the game, not even play it. The biggest controversy being that it didn't really seem to gain them anything by forfeiting.
That's right.
So there's a lot of opinions out there on both sides, and not a lot of favorable opinions towards the idea. But it was something they felt was important at the time. We'll see how it affects them in the future of the league. Back to the action.
There we go. We got V Diva out there. Oh, we've got a major block to the back, it looks like, by V Diva.
Wow.
So Lil Payne will have a power jam. Well, she's not your lead jammer, so she's going to have to skate the full 2 minutes.
A no pass, no penalty prevented her from getting the lead, but she's going to have a full minute without another jammer on the track as a third power jam given up now by Dutchland.
That's right. And Boston doing a good job. They got a pretty strong blocker line out there. They did have a Dutchland blocker trap. Now they're moving up to Little. Oh, wow. Lil Payne just splits the two. I thought they had a nice wall set up there, and she just squeezed on through them.
She did.
That's Hillbilly Hellcat out there and Bella Lablosi, the blockers for Dutchland. Oh, nice move by Lil Payne. A little outside-inside maneuver going around turn four there, and another five-point grand slam. Boston taking advantage of these mistakes by Dutchland.
pack slowing to a crawl with a segregated pack through turn two. Little Payne trying to make quick work of a three wall of orange and does so for another grand slam, 15 so far.
Yeah, right now we've got Bella Loblosa. You guys can see her on your screen there. She's stuck at the back there. That's allowing Boston to slow down the pack. Oh, Lil Payne, though, looks like she went right into the back there. And
that's going to be a major
major back block. That's right. She knocked down the Dutchman blocker, so we're trading power jams here.
Not only that, but the other power jam had ended, so V Diva going to get an opportunity for a full, or Dutchland anyway, going to get an opportunity for a full minute of power jam.
That's right. So Boston right now trying to control the front here to keep V Diva from getting any points. And Dutchland maybe skating a little too fast here. They probably don't quite have to keep up with Boston here.
V Diva trying to pick up anything in this power jam.
No, able to pick up 3 points, actually, on that. So Dutchland approaching double digits right there.
Dutchland with one blocker in the penalty box. Boston fielding a full pack for this next jam, but Dutchland will continue this next jam in a power jam.
And Boston does have a full pack, though. 4 blockers, and they are controlling the inside line. I know that was a problem for them yesterday versus London, really giving up the inside line. So clearly they've trying to adapt their strategy here.
Skid Ho off the line to take advantage of the second half of this power jam as she approaches the pack through the front straightaway. Doesn't find a line on the inside. And Shatterly keeping her back.
That's right. Lady Shatterly holding onto the back of Ivana Shankovic and doing a good job of sort of keeping her body in front of Skid Ho here. Oh, now Lady Shatterly has been trapped at the back. That's going to allow there to be a no-pack situation. And we finally have a lead jammer for Skid Ho, although over 30 seconds had gone by.
Indeed, and the power jam is over. So it's a power failure for Skid Ho, but still, she does have control of the jam.
That's right. Not quite tire power failure here as she's on her scoring pass, so she should be able to pick up some points, and if she calls off at the right time, be able to keep Lil Payne from scoring points, although right into the back there of Ginger Kid, but no back block was called. She was able to pick up 3 points.
Dutchland able to cross the double-digit mark for the total score, but Boston only 30 away from a century mark early. As we're just going into the second quarter.
And we want to remind you that Adam Wheels is the official wheel of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Again, that's Adam Wheels, A-T-O-M Wheels. Boston really staying out of penalty trouble. That was a big problem for them against Baltimore, against Charm City, and against London right now. They do have a full pack out there, though, right now.
Claire DeWay on the outside is the lead jammer, making quick work through turn two of the pack.
Nash Villain stuck at the back. Treasure Chest was trying to clear the way for her. And Claire DeWay on her scoring pass here. Looks like she might be eligible for the lap point if she was able to get through there.
Nash Villain getting tied up by a two wall going into turn one.
And that's Lois Carmen Dominator, LCD 011 for Boston with a nice block to the inside on Nash Villain.
Claire DeWay looks to get a whip on the outside through turns three and four and picks up the natural grand slam.
And Nash Villain is out on her first pass, but cleared away with about a 20-foot lead on her. We'll be trying to get back into the pack to get some more points.
Pack spreads out and then crawls to a stop as cleared away and Nash Villain run into the pack with speed. Jam gets called.
Okay. Looks like 3 additional points there for Claire DeWay. Or 4 additional points there for Claire DeWay. That's right.
9-point total and denied Dutchland of any additional points for themselves.
Boston on a roll. A lot of smiles on the track there for them right now. They were looking to come out strong and end their tournament strong. And so we're just over halfway through the first period. I'm sure they're happy with how things are turning out. Dutchland putting out V Diva right now. Trying change the momentum here against Sugar Hits for Boston. And Boston not wanting to waste time. They cause a no-pack.
V Diva jukes to the outside and quickly makes it through to be the lead jammer.
But Sugar Hits actually out as well in a hurry. This is good news for Dutchland as they were down 4-2 in the pack. So to get lead jammer is a big deal. They can kill off some of the time.
As long as they can stay out of the penalty box, as V-Diva calls off the jam, picks up four and allows one.
No, the other way around.
You're correct.
That was really risky maneuver by V-Diva right there. You know, I think she might have been better off just playing defense on Sugar Hits, running the penalty times down of her players who are in the penalty box. So now all that Sugar Hits had to do was pass one Dutchland blocker, and she got the two for the ones in the box. So
instead, she allowed the four.
The full four. So a tough break there for Dutchland, and a little pain out there for Boston right now. Try and keep their momentum going.
No pack being called.
That's right. And the Jammers weren't quite sure it was called.
White Thrash trying to force her way through the middle, coming into the back straightaway.
That's Anorexia give her a bump there, and Lil Payne snuck through. Oh, no, Lil Payne got a major forearm and actually skated past the point of no return for the penalty box. She's got to do a full lap here.
She was in disbelief looking at the call.
That's right. A forearms, they're such subtle penalties. They're something so hard to see or maybe even feel for the skaters out there. Then we've got a lead jammer for White Thrash and a power jam here. And a 4-3 pack advantage for Dutchland. It seems like a time that they are going to have to put some points on the board.
This could be a huge opportunity for a momentum shift as White Thrash moves to the inside of the back straightaway. But
wow, that was Anorexia knocking White Thrash out of bounds. Although I don't think a track cut was called. Maybe she did get one track cut for that. So there's 4 points on that pass.
Didn't pick up the full grand slam.
Oh, Shark Week. Nice block right there. Looks like maybe it was a direction of play penalty. Boston doing a pretty good job with this slow pack here playing defense, although they are picking up a lot of direction of play minors out there. Anorexia with a huge hit, and it looks like it was considered a clean hit here.
She picks up five more, but...
And you can see she's White Thrasher holding her chest, and so looks like she's a little bit shaken up. That was if she's holding her chest, clearly it was a legal target zone that Anorexia hit her on. The only question might have been whether or not it was a direction of play penalty, and it wasn't. So
just a brutal hit in turn four as Boston ramps up the aggressiveness in this game.
That's right. First whistle has blown here. There's a 3-3 pack here, a 4-3 pack now as Ginger Kid comes off the penalty box. For Boston, it's still a power jam for Skid Ho and Dutchland.
Skid Ho looking the inside, breaks through, and...
Oh, Bumpus, number 77 for Boston, just knocked Skid Ho just a little bit to the inside there, and Skid Ho didn't realize it and earned, unfortunately, a track cut for herself.
That's going to shift the power jam in the favor of Boston and in the hands of Little Payne.
A lot of power jams we've seen so far. I believe that's 2 for Dutch and maybe 4 or so for Boston.
Yeah, I've been commenting this entire tournament on how low the penalties have been, and that's not the case here in this bout. A grand slam for Little Payne. It's been very clean skating in most of the bouts that we've seen here at the East Region playoffs for the WFTDA.
Particularly London, actually. I noticed that they were not picking up a lot of penalties, and that's something that they work on. I'm not totally sure. But anyways, we've got some action on a track here. Lil Payne gotten her way through for a 5-point grand slam. If you see in that pack, we've got Boston in the back and Dutchland in the front here. So Dutchland should be able to run a little bit to keep Lil Payne from getting back in.
But we're not seeing it happen as Dutchland slows down.
That's right. They could speed up so gently, although you can't dramatically speed up as that would be destroying the pack. And we're going to have an empty penalty box in a matter of seconds as Anita Banger comes in for Boston.
Oh, but a snap goes right in.
Someone goes right in.
Final snap. Blocker for Dutchland.
And Lil Payne here again on another scoring pass, trying to get past Rum and Choke. Number 1, 2, 3, 4 for Dutchland. Nice blocking, though, by Rum and Choke. She's been helped out by Renegade Raven as well. And Twisted Scissors now taking a hit.
Giving a hit.
That's right.
Scissors
taking a hit. That's right. The incorrect verb here. 4 more points for Lil Payne there. Another big jam for Boston.
Boston. Ooh. Just edging up on that century mark as V-Diva for Dutchland lines up on the jammer line.
Yeah, Boston really very successful with their blockers right now in the pack right now, just controlling the pace of play and keeping their walls together. Dutchland not quite aggressive enough to break up those walls at this point, so they're really going to need to step it up if they're going to make a run. We've got Etta Mames here at the front of the pack for Boston. And, oh, a V Diva. Oh, just snuck right through. That's a major low block there on Bella Loblosi.
There you go.
Loblosi. Hey, Loblosi for low blocking. Does that make any sense?
A little bit. Claire DeWay also on her scoring run. But V Diva now. V Diva on the outside. Picks up only two
points. That's right.
Calls off the jam. V Diva has been powerful and effective in her initial pass, but time and time again, partly because of the speed of Claire DeWay that she's often matched up with, being able to catch up to her, unable to even make a full pass.
That's right. Boston's doing a good job getting their, even if it takes a little bit longer than Dutchland, getting their jammers out right after the Dutchland jammers. And again, that, like you said, that's just preventing Dutchland from getting any points, or getting a lot of points, I should say.
Another mass proposal set forth by Boston's Massacre.
And we've got Sugar Hits jamming here for Boston. Rum and Choke gave her a nice block. Hillbilly Hellcat chasing her down, and she sneaks out past Rum and Choke and is your lead jammer.
Skid Ho being shut down going into turn three. Gets recycled back into the pack and has yet to make her initial pass.
Yeah, she's facing up against Lady Shatterly and Bumpus there at the front of the pack. And Sugar Hits has lapped her and passed, and that's five more points for Boston, who's now crossed the century mark.
That was courtesy of Bumpus for putting Skid Ho down to the ground in turn one. And only now in the third lap does Skid Ho make her initial pass.
And Sugar Hits trying to squeeze through again here. Another pass. Looks like
a track cut, though. Looks like it was a minor.
Oh, that's right. Sugar Hits actually allowing Skid Ho through here.
Surprising.
Very surprising that she didn't call that off earlier. It's like a little bit of a mistake there. Maybe the first real mistake we've seen from Boston today. But nonetheless, Boston did pick up three. Dutchland looks like picked up 4 points there. So despite
total of eight.
That's right. That was her
Boston.
Second scoring pass for Sugar Hits. That's
so
right.
The advantage to the Massacre as Boston goes over the 100-point mark and leads by 74. Oh, excuse me. More points added. 77. I think they just like, they're waiting, and they like to prove us wrong.
That's right. They heard you say that, and they're like, ha-ha, watch what we're going to do.
Psych.
Jack it up. V Diva out there once again, and once again, Claire DeWay matched up against her.
V Diva looking to jack up the score of her team, Dutchland, who trails significantly regardless of what the tidbits are, and she is the lead jammer, just forcing her way through the pack.
That's right. The very powerful skating V Diva went against the very powerful skating Anorexia there and emerged victorious.
Anorexia has just been a force. Very powerful. I've seen her jam at least once, maybe a couple of times in this tournament, and effective there too, but what an amazing blocker as V Diva breezes through the pack.
And the points, 4 points on that pass. So Dutchland's got a little bit of, something going on now.
Seems like Dutchland's starting to feel their skates underneath them, get some nervousness. I can't imagine they would have nervousness at this point, but it just seems like they're relaxing more and playing more smoothly.
Absolutely. They're trying to keep it even, I think, right now is what you want to do. When you're losing by a lot, you want to start... let's start winning, let's start catching up. No, let's start playing even, and then let's try and swing the momentum in our direction. I think that's what Dutchland, it's kind of where they are right now. We've got a slow start to this pack, which is going to benefit Boston here because they are down 3-2.
White thrash on the line for Dutchland.
So an unusual decision here for Dutchland here to do a slow start. So Dutchland now 4-3 pack advantage, and our jammers are allowed to go. Lil Payne sort of creeping up, looking for her spot here. White Thrash, a little more aggressive here around the inside, then around Ginger Kid. Lead jammer for Dutchland, who's got, like we said, maybe swinging the tides here a little bit.
Indeed. Being a little more cautious through the pack, not being so quick in avoiding those penalties as they gave up several power jams to create this massive split in the score. Both girls as on the scoring run is Lil Payne out, but White Thrash now.
Yeah, looks like she took a hit from Bump. Oh, she might have almost picked up a track cut at the end before the fourth whistle, but they didn't give it to her. She was able to pick up 2 points right there, and Dutchland continues to close the gap.
Hillbilly Hellcat going to the penalty box, blocker for Dutchland there in the middle of that jam. I actually thought that was going to be the jammer.
You can see White Thrash taking a seat there and slamming shots there, bench coach. Assigning positions there, and we've got Sugar Hits, the jammer for Boston right now. And she is going around the outside here on turn one and two.
Skid Ho caught in the back behind Dixie, kicks and takes a spill as Dixie puts her to the ground in the back straightaway.
That's a nice solid booty blocking by Dixie Kicks. That's definitely her specialty. And Sugar Hits avoiding the track cut there and is your lead jammer for Boston. And Dixie Kicks hasn't gotten that much playing time this weekend, but when she's in there, she's making it count.
Roman Choke trying to make the stop, but Sugar Hits just thinning past her on the inside.
Nice block by Anna Rexia on Skid Ho. And Sugar Hits here on her scoring pass.
Skid Ho still unable to make her initial pass, and this will be what looks to be, it is a natural grand slam for Sugar Hits.
Dixie Kicks once again giving a knock to Skid Ho. Rum and Choke here and Twisted Scissors doing their darndest to clear through that Boston wall and make a way for Skid Ho to get through. Oh, but we've got a track cut called on Skid Ho. Another power jam for Boston, and she is winded. It's taken her quite some time to skate around here to the penalty area.
This is insult to injury at this point with this many power jams being given up. And coming up in just 45 seconds left on the period clock, this could be the last jam of the half.
That's
Dutchland's
right.
Really going to have to reorganize in the locker room.
Oh, nice block by Hillbilly Hellcat there on Sugar Hits, slowing her down. That might save them a few points here. We have only 16 seconds left in the jam, so this will probably be the last pass. And calling off the jam was Sugar Hits. Three additional points picked up. And the clock's going to tick down. Unless somebody calls a timeout, we are going to run out the period. Although Singer Macho Solo, the jam coach for Boston, has called the timeout with 2 seconds left. That's a guy who's watched a lot of sports throughout his life and knows what he's doing. We want to tell you about some of our sponsors right now.
Absolutely. If you're in Derby and you need, or your team needs, some Derby wear, check out Iron Doll. Iron Doll Clothing, for all of your uniform needs, has provided fantastic uniforms and derby wear for teams all over the country.
And we also want to tell you about Vanilla Skates. So while you get our Iron Doll takes care of your clothing, Vanilla Skates can take care of your skates. Let Vanilla Derby take you to success with our brand new top grain leather Renegade and straight jacket boots. That's Vanilla Skates.
And don't forget about just what's on the outside. Think about what's on the inside. Derby is hard. You need to hydrate yourself. And a big thanks to Vitamin Water for helping that happen here in this tournament. Vitamin Water, providing hydration to skaters and officials here and everywhere.
That's right, everywhere. I like
everywhere.
That. Vitamin Water, just walk down the street, you're just going to get Vitamin Water. If you just go, I'm a skater, I'm an official, they're just throwing it at you out their windows.
They actually make it condensate, so it rains Vitamin Water occasionally. That'd
be cool. We have a tiny pack for, there we go, cleared away, just sneaking right through. Only one blocker at the moment was on the track for Dutchland because another one was standing up in the penalty box. So 4-2 pack advantage here for Clarity Way.
And wow, Clarity Way with a hop on the outside picks up a grand slam, and she is in a power jam.
As you can see why Senor Macho Solo called that timeout there for Boston, wanting to just get a larger lead going into halftime. A lot of psychological things about being up by 100 or so. A lot of psychological stuff that comes with that.
Very difficult to stay in the proper mindset to overcome it. These kind of spreads have been overcome, but it's overcoming the psychological game, as you were talking about, that tends to be the most difficult part of that.
That's right. Oh, cleared away. Almost kept herself from falling there. She was on one skate for almost a whole turn, but she did hit the deck. Ginger Kid and Renegade Raven having a little battle at the front there. Oh, my. Is this another power jam?
It might be. Skid Ho took a spill. Hard hit.
No, it is not. Okay, that was Etta Mames being called off there with a major. And Skid Ho really winded here, trying to get through on her first pass. Cleared away with another 5-point grand slam. And she is approaching the back of the pack right now, about 10 feet behind it.
Skid Ho. Honor scoring run, but Clarity Way has been unstoppable.
As she has, oh, there she goes through on one skate. Passes Rumenchoke, calls off the jam. Four more points for Boston. So going into halftime, almost have that 100-point lead that maybe they were looking for, but 131 for Boston. Dutchland, 34.
Wow, what an incredible first half. We're going to be bringing you an exciting second half. Late Night Lyle here, along with Kevin Up. And actually, for me anyway, a surprising first half. I know you know Boston extremely well. Are you equally surprised, or did you expect this?
I am. You're absolutely correct. I'm equally surprised. You see, when Boston played Dutchland the first time around at ECDX, they were actually really close until Boston started finally pulling away in the second half. And this is the other way around. Boston really got control of this bout early with some early mistakes and power jams by Dutchland, and really haven't looked back.
Well, it's not just the ability of Boston, but the, if you'll forgive the wording, the disability of Dutchland.
I'd say in, that's a little nicer prefix.
Right. Yeah. As Dutchland has dropped several power jams that Boston has been able to really take advantage of and post a major point spread on the board with almost a 100-point difference between the two. We're here at the Dew Burns Arena in Baltimore, Maryland. You're watching on WFTDA.com for day three of this Eastern Region playoffs, which is brought to you by, in part, Rydell Skates. Rydell Skates, a proud partner in the official skate of the WFTDA. Whether you're brand new or a seasoned veteran, pick up some Rydells today.
Also, Union Vacations, a sponsor of the WFTDA Championships. Union Vacations is proud to provide the 2011 Women's Flat Track Derby Association MVP with a one-week getaway to Mexico.
Already checked several times. We are not eligible for that. A bit upset.
You tried? Most Valuable Announcer Award?
Most Valuable Announcer. That'd be great. We'd get a free trip to, like, Pittsburgh or something.
Hey, Pittsburgh's nice. I was there this year. All right, well, we've got a 4-2 pack advantage to start off. V-Diva out there against, of course, Claire DeWay. V-Diva getting through and getting lead jammer. Lost her footing, but Claire DeWay stuck at the back of the pack. Oh, and right now, it's only bump. It's Claire DeWay on three. And somehow a no-pack situation was called there. So that allowed Claire DeWay through. Huge break for Boston.
And Boston, down two blockers, just a half a pack out there with Dutchland, a full pack. And Bumpus now going to the penalty box.
That's
and
right.
So for the moment, Boston with only a single blocker on the track.
And I'm a little bit confused here is why V-Diva did not call off the jam right there when she had the 4-0. She's now going for more. And really, maybe let's see what she ended up with here. She might have gotten some extra points.
She did not.
That pass.
She posted none
and gave up one. So that's actually a loss there for Dutchland, a costly mistake.
Incredible. You would not expect to see that from Dutchland or anyone at the tournament level.
Right. The only thought that I have is that maybe V-Diva and her jam coach over there, that's Merv the Perv, maybe they thought with such a small Boston pack, they just wanted to keep it going and assume that they could keep Claire DeWay from getting through. Really, you should be able to keep Claire DeWay from getting through if you have four blockers on one blocker out there.
You should, especially with the talent of V-Diva. Both V-Diva, as you mentioned before, and Claire DeWay on Team USA. And you just have to wonder if maybe frustration from not only controversial events, but the score here in this bout is really affecting the mindset of Dutchland. Skid Ho through the pack. She's the lead jammer for Dutchland. So the second jam of this second half, and both being taken advantage of by Dutchland, but
that's right. They've got some serious pack advantages here. Now Skid Ho is through. That is a 5-point grand slam now. So Boston, a bit of penalty trouble here. So good opportunity for Dutchland to come out of the gates here in the second and a half.
Sugar Hints now out of the pack. Both girls are in a scoring run, but with one natural grand slam in the books, Skid Ho goes to the outside, calls off the jam, and posts
three. Probably 3 points. That's 3 points right there. She passed one blocker on the
right
track. There were two in the penalty box. And so that was the right decision there, calling it off after earning the points, not allowing Boston's jammer Sugar Hits to get any points.
That's what we would have expected to see in the previous, but just did not play out that way. So perhaps maybe a little lack of pack awareness or something.
Well, bygones, though. Let's see if V-Diva's got it a little more under control this time. Now Dutchland taking a knee. They haven't done that despite their 4-2 pack advantages that they've had. Now they have a 3-2 advantage. They're doing it. V-Diva bumped out of bounds by Anita Banger.
Anita Banger with a beautiful move. And the power jam is over. It's a little pain.
Shark Week taking a hit at V Diva. They are staring each other down. V Diva is out. She's not your lead jammer. Lil Payne is. There was some fierce battling in there between Shark Week and V Diva.
4 points for Lil Payne as she calls off the jam. And
the Boston doing a good job there, despite being down 3-2 in the pack. That was all Anita Banger, like we saw that right on the first straightaway there, just bumping V Diva out of bounds, and that made all the difference. Allowed Lil Payne to get lead jammer.
Just a very quick hit move, and allows Boston to post 4 more unanswered points, which has been commonplace here in this bout as Dutchland tries for the mass proposal again.
All right. Oh, immediate no-pack situation, but they left the outside open for Clarity Way, who before maybe after 2 strides maybe had earned lead jammer status.
Wow. That Clarity Way just jetting through on the outside, picking up lead before even the pivot line. White Thrash was on her scoring run, but Clarity Way calls off the jam before she can pass a single opposing blocker.
You know, we watch a lot of teams take a knee, but sometimes it's not perfectly rehearsed. And you take a knee, but you're just doing that to get the jam started right away. And you're not really fully aware of where you are and where you need to be and where the other team's jammer is. And that's a perfect example right there with Claire DeWay just sneaking through, like we said, maybe 2 or 3 steps out.
And we're seeing it again, this time by Boston with the mass proposal, but it's something that with teams at a non-tournament level, I see it used all the time completely ineffectively.
Yep.
We've been seeing it very effectively in this tournament here. Sugar hits out of the pack through turn 2. She's the lead jammer. And Skid Ho, I believe.
Yes, that is Skid Ho out there. She is about maybe a quarter lap behind Sugar Hits right now. Anorexia being sent to the penalty box. So another pack advantage here for Dutchland. Sugar Hits not taking any risk calling it off, but able to pick up 2 points. Should be happy with that.
Points, but we've seen it very effective here, but it's not just an initial timing, but a setup. So many times with younger leagues, we'll see them let it go too soon, and it'd be completely worthless. We've seen it used very effectively at the tournament level, but Dutchland against a jammer like Claire DeWay, or in this case, Anita Payne.
That's Lil Payne out there. That's right. And she is just stuck behind a wall there. But yes, it could absolutely backfire if it's not executed in the right way. Although they did it right this time with the 4-2 advantage here and able to get V Diva out quickly. Let's see if V Diva's got a good sense here of where Lil Payne is.
Oh,
just knocking into Lady Shatterly. A big size disadvantage there for Lady Shatterly and 4 points and correctly called off by V Diva.
V Diva doing it by the books and absolutely.
We want to tell you about another sponsor of the East Region playoffs here, ProTech Dent Mouthguards, the first thoroughly scientific mouthguard for the Derby player, ProTech Dent Mouthguards. All right, and we are going to start with 1 massacre blocker in the penalty box. That's Anorexia. And our jammers are getting ready to get off the line. Looks like that might be Claire D. Way over there.
Could be.
Yes, it is.
You're right, yes. Claire D. Way on the outside.
That's White
Looks
Thrash.
Looks to the inside and gets some help, but breaks through and becomes the lead jammer.
A White Thrash now stuck in the pack. She's got Lois Carmen Dominator and Ivana Shankovic to beat. This pack is getting pretty spread out, so the LCD doesn't want to risk it. She lets White Thrash go. Claire D. Way, though, already under scoring pass. Dutchland now aware of her presence, setting up a little 3-person wall at the front. Nice job tightening up their wall here. They've got to let her go. She calls off the jam. Let's see if it was in time. It was not quite in time. 3 points earned by Dutchland, but 4 for Clarity Way. A little bit of a delay between the call off and when the whistles took place there. Just 1, maybe 2 seconds. Sometimes you have to start calling it off before you actually want it called off.
It was just some fantastic pack work by Dutchland, but Clarity Way able to to make herself paper thin, skim through the inside of the front straightaway, and pick up those extra points. But again, not quite in time to not allow those points.
We've got a full pack out there. Oh, and Skid Ho quickly taking advantage of that for Dutchland. And Sugar hits the jammer for Boston, going around turn three here, trying to get her way through.
Sugar hits, looking to the inside of the front straightaway, breaks through, and she's on her scoring run.
That's right, Skid Ho now approaching the back of the pack, and she has entered into it. She's got that wall of four Boston blockers at the front who really tightened things down. She's gotten around. It's like Lady Shatterly there. Skid Ho got a call off the jam. 2 points earned, so good defensive stand there for Boston.
Banger preventing the full four, pushing her to the inside of the front straightaway, forcing her to call off the jam.
Another sponsor of the WFTDA Championships is BuyNewSkates.com. It's pretty obvious what they do. So go to BuyNewSkates.com.
Pretty easy one to remember. V Diva on the line for Dutchland. And a timeout being called, a team timeout by the Boston Massacre.
That's right. Boston looks like they want to talk about a little strategy there. That's Senor Macho Solo out there in the huddle. He's been their jam coach for quite some time now, and they trust it. They trust that he's got some good ideas out there.
You know where else you can get some good ideas?
Where else can we get some good ideas? Late Night Lyle.
5 on 5.
That's right.
5 on 5 magazine has fantastic news and articles on all things skate related, including your favorite sport, roller derby. Check them out. 5on5.com.
Then if you want to be a fast skater, you're going to want to check out some skates from Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates is the industry pioneer in boot sizing and configuration for women's feet. Split, last, and narrow skates are in stock and ready to ship to you. That's Fast Girl Skates.
Also, if you're over 21 and want to get hammered, Flying Dog Brewery. Flying Dog, the official beer of the 2011 WFTDA East Region Playoffs.
Of course, you are allowed to not get hammered and drink Flying Dog.
Absolutely.
One's fine. You know, that's your thing.
Drink responsibly.
Yes,
please. Don't drink and drive.
Okay, we are back with some derby action here. We've got Claire D. Way, the jammer for Boston, against V. Diva for Dutchland. A very slow start here. V. Diva in defensive mode.
Ooh.
Pushing her way through LCD and anorexia, but Clarity White found the hole first, and she's your lead jammer.
V. Diva being extremely aggressive through the pack now makes her initial pass.
That's right. V. Diva just sort of turns on the jets and plows into people to get them out of her way.
Bumpus being sent to the penalty box. Blocker for Boston as Clarity Way breaks through, picks up four more for Boston.
You know, Milkmaid number 12-12 for Dutchland. Milkmaid actually had great position on Claire DeWay there. Just didn't realize that Claire was there. Being on the far side of the track from her coach, the coach is unable to yell and say, hey, she's right there next to you. And she snuck on by for quick 4 points.
Boston now with a solid 100-point lead.
Well, that's convenient.
It is. Especially for those of us who aren't very good at math.
Fives at the end, you know. Very, very nice.
Little pain on the line for the Boston Massacre up against Skid Ho. No, I'm wrong about that. That's White Thrash.
That is White Thrash, and Shark Week taking a tumble in front of White Thrash. No low block called, though. Shark Week just doing a little one-on-one blocking at the back on her as Lil Payne approaches the front of the pack.
Lil Payne trying to squeeze past Rum and Choke, but Rum and Choke holding her back effectively. And finding her way through. She is the lead jammer, but a very defensive jam eats off the first 30 seconds, 40 seconds, before we even have a jammer on a scoring run.
All right, and we've got White Thrash here approaching the back of the pack. Let's get some points here for some much-needed points here for Dutchland. And she calls off the jam, 2 points. So even when we're seeing Dutchland get lead jammer, really only usually able to only earn about 2 points. Haven't really seen many 4-0 jams for Dutchland.
They're not able to hold Boston's jammer for very long at all. We haven't been able to see that level of defense in this game out of Dutchland, being able to contain Boston's jammers. Of course, Boston's jammers have been extremely effective.
That's right.
And very agile, but
the key really has been that Boston Chambers have gotten out quickly. So then, or the other way around, actually, is that Boston just going quickly from defense to offensive shift that's oh so important in roller derby.
Sure, oh, so important.
Bouncing off of several Dutchland blockers.
Yep.
And they get spread too far out and have to let her go. Sugar Hits as the lead jammer.
We're going to have a power jam here for Boston. Didn't quite see what the call was, but Sugar Hits will have a 1 minute power jam right here. Swing and a miss at the back there by Nash Villain, who is trapped and not moving right now. Looks like a direction of play minor was called on one of the Boston skaters there and reformed the pack now.
Natural grand slam for Sugar Hits. Five already, and she looks to make it 10.
There she goes. Looks like she picked up a minor track cut there, so probably, yep, just 4 points. So she's got to watch her minors here, make sure she doesn't foul out. I mean, gets into the box with fourth minor. Ivana Shankovic here getting up there and playing some offense for Boston. Of a 4-3 pack advantage, and Sugar Hits through.
Another five for Sugar, and that's going to make it 14.
Yes, it is. That's right. So a very successful jam here for Boston. Once again, a power jam. Boston executing to perfection today.
Boston losing another blocker to the penalty box. Sugar Hits.
Treasure Chest taking a swing at her. Now there goes Milk Maiden, but Sugar Hits goes around and 4 points right there. So she may have picked up quite a few minors here on this jam, so she's got to watch herself.
Oh, no. Another. The power jam was over, but Skin Ho going right back to the penalty box.
Was that an illegal procedure there? I missed the call.
I did as well. It was back in turn four.
That's right. I'm assuming that was a legal procedure, maybe entering the wrong part of the pack. You do need to enter when any time a jammer or blocker coming out of the penalty box. We're going to have to assume that that's going to be an illegal procedure there on her coming in front of the pack instead of in the very back of the pack.
Possibly.
In a way, you really do want to come in, especially as a jammer, you want to come in at the back because you got to pass everybody in order to get points. So Claire D. Way going to have a power jam now for Boston once again. She's got Ginger Kid and Anorexia out there. Break things up. Try and get her through.
Claire D. Way looks to the middle. Goes to the outside. Doesn't find a path. Goes to the inside. And it's going to be a track cut. Is it going to be major?
Yes, it was. Okay, so we're going to switch up. And she's going to now sit for as long as the Dutchland jammer sat.
The previous one was actually Skid Hose was a track cut. We just got information on that.
Great.
But she's back on the track now, and she is the lead jammer with an opportunity here, although it'll only be about a half of a power jam.
Oh, Ginger Kid. Oh, yep, that's right. A major block in the back. Ginger Kid just putting her booty in front of Skid Ho there, who could not control her speed and just knocked Ginger Kid right down.
And this will be a full minute for Skid Ho in the penalty box. And as it sends.
Okay, and we're looking for a Boston jammer. Here we go. A Boston jammer coming out. Claire D. Way. Maybe just less than a full minute that Skid Ho will have to sit. We shall see.
Claire D. Way on the inside. And that's going to count as her initial pass. No initial pass first, as she got sent to the penalty box before passing all the opposing, or before making a full pass.
Pass.
Little tongue tied.
Whoa! Ducking around turn four right there was Clarity Way. Like we said, she likes to skate low. It sometimes backfires, and she gets just absolutely whacked by someone's behind, but it worked out there.
It's a beautiful thing when it pays off, and Clarity Way already with five.
Looks like time expired there. She's calling for some points, and she gets the points that she wanted. Boston's bench.
Wow.
Very pleased with the results of that.
And we have a timeout being called. Nope. No, he's not. I thought he was going to try to call for an official review.
Looks like
he was asking to see if there was a lap point there. A five. Said he wasn't being given.
All right. And we've got Boston taking a knee here to start off this jam to get it started quickly. Lil Payne coming out.
Lil Payne on down on the inside of turn two.
It's like Milk Maiden took her out to the inside there.
The power jam is over. Skid Ho is back on the track. Currently, Boston down two blockers, and that's going to help Skid Ho break through to be the lead jammer.
There she goes, and Lil Payne still getting through on her first scoring pass here. Twisted Scissors in there. Bella Leblosi giving her a tough time, as is Milk Maiden.
Dutchland with a full pack as Skid Ho calls off the jam, but picks up the grand slam.
So interesting decision to call off the jam there. She still had lead jammer, and there was really only one Boston blocker in the pack, as Boston currently has two blockers sitting in the penalty box, one standing. So even though she hit the deck and lost her momentum, may have behooved her just to continue on going there. But we shall see how it works out.
Been the story all tournament long for Dutchland. Interesting decision.
We've got a new jammer out there for Boston. That's Ginger Kid, number 43. She usually has the red helmet, but now she's got the star in her helmet, so you can't tell. She's going up against the one, the only V Diva. So this will be an interesting experience for Ginger Kid. Look, we have a timeout called by Boston. We'll tell you about some of our sponsors here. Five Stride Skate Shop, the preferred skate shop of Bonnie Thunders, Deranged Psychobabble, Susie Hot Rod, and Teflon Donna. Five Stride Skate Shop, a sponsor of the WFTDA Championships.
Also, don't forget to make your new Derby photo book made by Jules Doyle Photography. Axel Adams at NoMercyBook.com. This will be an official review. As the officials are discussing,
it looks like it started off it's actually a team timeout that looks like it's been sort of elevated into an official review here.
Right.
That's oftentimes a strategy. I know I'm good friends with Boston's jam coach there, Senor Macho Solo, and he tells me, you know, sometimes he'll call a timeout to stop play so that he can have a conversation with the officials, not even with his teams, and be like, yo, guys, you got to talk, or girls, ladies, you have to talk something over. Here's, you got to figure this out, and, we'll let you know if we find something out there. In the meantime,
the official's discretion to change that team timeout to an official timeout,
yep.
So to not charge the team with it.
Okay, and we'll tell you about Spenlin Media, another sponsor of the WFTDA Championships. Spenlin Media, you need it, we make it. Apparel, websites, and the rules app for your phone. Spenlin, S-P-E-N-L-E-N Media. All right, looks like he is the challenge here. Senor Macho Solo, the coach there for Boston, has challenged the score. We believe there will be no change actually made.
Yep.
And it looks like we're going to be back underway.
Here we go.
And again, we've got one blocker right now, Anorexia. So there's a tall order for Ginger Kid here in her first jam as a jammer.
Wow.
Going against V-Diva with only one blocker at the moment to help her out.
V-Diva with three up front. Mass Proposal. But wow. Anorexia trying to take out V-Diva.
That's right.
Diva bounces it off and picks up lead jammer. But nice move again.
Yeah, just to get a body on V-Diva there. It was very impressive. And Ginger Kid making it through before her first pass. The first lap was done right there. So going to limit the damage here. Ivana Shankovic and Anorexia. Running into V-Diva, who is just too strong.
V-Diva not just strong, but manages to keep a skate on the inside and thread the needle through the outside of turn two to pick up those points. Just impressive power and stability by V-Diva.
That's right. And once again, Senor Macho Solo out there seems to have something to say after every single jam. So it wants to let them know he's looking at them, watching their every move. And anyways, but back to the track. We've got a 3-2 pack advantage here for Dutchland. Lady Shatterly and Bumpus, it looks like, number 77, the blockers out there for Boston. Going to try and hold back.
Pack off to a almost dead stop start. Finally let the jammers go.
Yeah, that's Claire D. Way and White Thrash out there. Renegade Raven, nice block on Claire D. Way.
White Thrash on the outside, moves to the inside of the back straightaway and is the lead jammer.
No, Claire D. Way hot on her tail right now. One of the fastest skaters in the league, in WFTDA, and just about passing White Thrash, although not quite. White Thrash doing a good job with positioning here. And Clarity Way forcing the call off there with some serious speed skating.
But see, Kevin, this is what we've been talking about. When Boston Jammer is able to break through the pack, they usually have quite a bit of room, if not a few laps, to be able to pick up some points. Dutchland, when they get their jammer out first, they're not able to contain Boston's jammer, and so they're not able to pick up a sizable amount of points, usually just in small amounts of one and two. And it's translating, plus giving up all those power jams, mm-hmm. is translating to the huge differential that we see here.
That's right. And Boston, really, I think a little pain maybe went to the penalty box two times in the first period to give a couple power jams to Dutchland. But otherwise, I believe they've skated pretty clean. There's a couple little short power jams that were given up in the second half here. So we got V Diva here against, that's number 27, Ivana Shankovic. V Diva getting another lead jammer status.
V Diva.
She is
quick work on the outside.
She is cruising around the track there in a hurry. But the pack is moving at a pretty good clip here.
And, you know, we just talked about this. Shank only now breaking through the pack, so
this should be eligible for enough time here for a full pass for V Diva. Although Boston's blockers at the front have really slowed it down.
And she calls off the jam.
Only 2 points there for V Diva, but she called it off because Shank was approaching the back of the pack there, and there was a bunch of Dutchland blockers at the back there. The pack was so spread out though, I'm not exactly sure where the pack definition was.
They increased it to 3, but still okay. Not a full pass. And I think we're both expecting, with the separation of those two jammers, that we at least see a full pass that time.
That's right.
Boston able to shut it down again.
Clarity Way, the jammer out there for Boston with 3 blockers on her side. We've got 4 blockers out there for Dutchland. And Crash Daly blocking our view.
That's... Oh...
Okay, we got Renegade Raven, actually. I think this might be her first jam as a jammer today.
It is.
Number 935 for Dutchland.
Claire DeWay jamming for Boston. Claire DeWay on the outside, but it is Renegade breaking through first. She's the lead jammer.
And she's got a power jam here as Claire DeWay was sent to the penalty box, so a good opportunity for Dutchland to get a little momentum on their side as we're under the 9-minute mark to go.
Boston. Renegade. On the outside, avoids a couple of quick blocks and skates past Bumpus, who just lets her go to pick up a grand slam.
And Bumpus not wanting to risk picking up a penalty there. And that was Nash Villain doing some good offensive blocking. Nita Banger now going out. So we've got a 4-2 pack advantage for Boston. That is Lois Carmen Dominator and Bumpus out there trying to keep the position at the front. Good offensive blocking though by Dutchland, but somehow Bumpus, now Etta Mames and Lois Carmen Dominator, maintaining their position.
Through the middle of the front straightaway, it's going to be another grand slam for Renegade as an unexpected breath of fresh air for Dutchland.
That's right. A much needed breath of fresh air here for Dutchland and their fans. We've been looking for something to cheer for. And they've actually played a pretty tight second period. It was about a 100-point lead at half, and it's still just about a 100-point lead for Boston.
They definitely made some key changes and have been able to get back into this, but not really shift the tide, so to speak. But Renegade doing her best here. The power jam is over, and Claire DeWay picking up a 4 before the jam ends.
Well, that's interesting. Claire DeWay was indeed on, I guess she was on her scoring pass there, and she came out and so able to pick up some points. We want to tell you about Jules Doyle Photography. You can pick up your new photo book, their new Derby photo book from Jules Axel Adams Doyle, nomercybook.com, nomercybook.com.
Don't forget, if you're on skates, you want to be on Adam Wheels. Adam Wheels, the official wheel of the WFTDA. Back to the action.
The Dr. Hauschka start jam line here. We've got jammers from both teams. That was like Lil Payne for Boston, number 451 degrees. And Twisted Scissors, number 40. We haven't really seen her jamming tonight either.
This is her first jam as well. So Dutchland posting 2 first-time jammers and 2 jams. But it's Lil Payne out of the pack first. She's the lead jammer. Scissors still unable to make her initial pass, and oh,
big hit by Anorexia. Oh, but Treasure Chest doing a nice clear out of Anorexia there. It's number 777 for Dutchland.
But a waterfall maneuver keeps Scissors recycled in the pack, and she's still unable. Shark Week shuts her down on the inside of turn 2.
And it was sort of being called out for that. Maybe it was a major forearm, I believe.
It was.
And Lil Payne here getting through.
Natural Grand Slam.
That's right. Oh, so natural Grand Slam. And there looks like a major forearm there, perhaps, called on Bella Loblosi. And our Dutchland jammer is finally out. That's Twisted Scissors.
50 seconds left in the jam. And Dutchland.
Yeah, Lil Payne not messing around. She's already passed one blocker. She's going to get a point for the one in the box as well. So she's able to pick up 2 points. I'm going to tell you about Blood and Thunder Magazine, sponsor of WFTDA Championships here. Worldwide Roller Derby coverage and the first ever World Cup will be covered by Blood and Thunder Magazine.
World Cup will be in Toronto in December. And that's what we've been talking about. A couple of the girls, one girl from each team, two of the jammers. Mm-hmm. On Team USA, several countries, double digits of countries represented at the World Cup. It'll be incredible. If you haven't seen the Team USA logo, you can pick up their merchandise as well. They need your support. Go to their website. More information on that a little later. V. Diva going into a blocking position against Claire DeWay.
That's not going to do her any good. They are losing, so Claire DeWay is happy to just waste her time.
Yeah.
Oh, but then V. Diva could just explode through everybody. So she just, it was kind of like one of those matchbox cars. You sort of pull them back, and all of a sudden release and flies right through.
That was some impressive power to burst through the pack. But Clarity Way also on her scoring run now.
Nice.
V. Diva on the inside picking up 4. That's the first.
And she stops right at the jam line for the next jam. And it's a good sportswomanship there as she high-fived Claire DeWay on the way by. Those two are fierce competitors, care a lot about winning and the success of their teams. I want to tell you about Derby Skins. Derby Skins, if you are unpleased with the look of your hiney, Derby Skins loves making your hiney shiny. Derby Skins, that's a Z at the end.
I think this is Shank on the line for Boston.
Yes, it is, number 27, and once again, V. Diva, and they're having a little laugh over there. And it's like we're going to have a little bit of a timeout. We can tell you about another one of our sponsors, Green Monster Roller Sports, a.k.a. Heartless. They've got antic boots, reckless wheels, and moto bearings. They are revolutionizing roller derby. Green Monster Roller Sports.
Also want to remind you that if you haven't yet filled out all of your brackets, it's not too late. Go to WFTDA.com on the bracket maker, fill out your brackets, and if you're correct, you can win. If you've already filled out all your brackets and you're correct through the entire Big Five, you can win a massive prize, all expense paid trip to next year's WFTDA World Championships.
That is epic. It's going to be awesome.
It is indeed. This year's will be in Denver, Colorado in November. And Shank just dancing around behind V. Diva.
And they're having a good time out there. And Shank skipping through on the inside. The crowd absolutely loving that. Ivana Shankovic has a lot of family members here who made the trip. V. Diva.
Oh, a little taunting there as V. Diva.
The backwards block against Shank. They're having a good time on the track. I love to see that.
These
maybe. No low block call there. It was considered legit.
Balls it off. A little high five there between the two jammers.
That is awesome.
Excellent sportsmanship between these two jammers and these two teams.
That's right. And the crowd really showing their appreciation for that. Just, you know, anytime that you see the players on the track, you know, sort of lose that competitive edge and just have a little fun. We love to see that. That's what makes roller derby such a special sport.
Dutchland with the mass proposal up on the pivot line. Jammers get let go. And Claire DeWay trying to fight her way through the outside. White Thrash getting pushed back to the back. Claire DeWay unable to find her way past a solid wall, but now does so. She's the lead jammer breaking through. Turn 3.
And she did that classic shirt whip. You sort of grab the shirt of your teammate and just launch yourself. White Thrash is through as well.
But Claire DeWay already threw the pack on her first scoring pass. Four more points as she calls off the jam.
That's right. And we want to tell you about Derby Supply. They have the best customer service in the business, period. That is Derby Supply. And also want to talk to you about Merch Mama. They are supplying swag to the Derby Nation. That's Merch Mama, MAMA.com.
Next jam gets underway as Boston just 2 points away from the 200 mark. We're coming up on the 2 minute mark of this bout. As Little Payne.
This will actually be the first time. This will actually be the first time this year that Boston will have reached the 200 mark. They got to 199 against Jet City, so looks like they're maybe going to reach it if Lil Payne can get through here.
She's up against Scissors. And Lil Payne getting...
No, I think I think we've got ourselves a fourth minor on Twisted Scissors, so this is going to be a power jam. Here, one of our last jams here, and that's Lil Payne through as your lead jammer. Looks like they will most likely get that 200 mark.
Lil Payne with that shirt whip by Mames giving the assist. And so this is all but said and done.
That's right. We are approaching the 1 minute mark in both the jam clock and the period clock here.
Lil Payne on the outside gets shoved out hard.
But that was a no pass, no penalty. She did not get the point there for passing Treasure Chest. But she's gotten some points here. Lil Payne is through, and Boston's gotten 4 points, crossing the 200 mark for the first time all year. Okay, Lil Payne going to go ahead and try for another pass. Still 40 seconds left in the jam clock. Treasure Chest hit the deck, and she is caught at the back. Lil Payne on her own at the front to sort of push out those Dutchland blockers. She has gotten through for a five-point grand slam.
9 points so far for Lil Payne as we're got 20 seconds left in the period. Scissors back on the track. Twisted Scissors ending the power jam, but Lil Payne ending the jam.
Unless we got unless we have a timeout here, we are going to have the end. Oh, Senor Macho Solo, you little jerk, calling the timeout for Boston. What a punk. With 1 second left. Not sure what his motive is for that. But whatever. It gives us a chance to talk about some more of our sponsors. Ice Courts is a sponsor of the WFTDA Championship. Take your league to the next level with Skate Court, Roller Derby, Flat Tracks. Ice Courts.
Also, thanks to Sin City Skates. Sin City Skates is ready to fix your gear or chat about new stuff. By all means, check out Sin City Skates, proud sponsor of the WFTDA.
And while we've talked about Flying Dog beer and vitamin water, we want to tell you about another drink that sponsors the WFTDA Championships, the Honest Tea. Honest Tea was actually donated for all the volunteers here, so we thank Honest Tea for their donation.
We have Honest Tea at our snack table. You should have it at yours.
All right, so we're going to have one more jam here, and really close to the Dr. Hauschka jam line there. Every skater that's on the track.
Dutchland with a mass proposal for what will almost certainly be the final jam.
Almost certainly, that's right.
Yes.
If this is not the final jam, that's amazing. That would only be the decision of the head referee that would cause that. And V Diva out there to try and punish Boston for asking for one more jam. And she has gotten the lead jammer.
Claire DeWay also through. Both jammers on their scoring run and moving at a blistering pace around the track.
And V Diva gonna get a scoring pass here, and she's gonna keep on going right back at you, Boston. She could call off the jam, but you know what? Why not just keep playing roller derby? It's fun.
Yeah.
It looks fun, at least. I can't say I've ever suited up and played, but it looks like a really fun game to play.
They look like they're having a blast. 4 points each. It's currently a wash, but it looks like they're gonna let this one go the full 2 minutes.
Why not? Everybody came here. All these paying customers want to watch some roller derby, and they're going to get some right now. Nice hit by Hillbilly Hellcat there on Bumpus.
The Diva does call off the
there
jam at the minute mark, adding one but allowing two, and the advantage in the final jam goes to Boston. And wow. What a... What a game. What an unexpected game. But Boston dominant against Dutchland.
That's right. 213 for Boston. Like we said, the first time passing 200 this year for them. I'm sure they're very excited and they'll have a good go home with a good feeling. And Dutchland, 90, going home with a 1-3 record here. Stay tuned. You don't want to go far, folks. We got a couple things coming up. We're going to have an interview for you in about 2 minutes. And also, the next bout coming up at 1 o'clock is number 10 seed London taking on number 5 seed Montreal. They are going to be fighting for the 5th and 6th place spots.
And I tell you, as a fan myself, I can't wait for that bout. It is going to be so much fun to watch. London has been beautiful this entire tournament. Even in their losses, it's been just something to watch.
It's
their
been
last
very
bout,
pristine, yep.
They consistently, in their last bout last night, got their jammer out very quickly, got lead jammer very often, and consistently was able to get their jammer, the lead jammer status,
mm-hmm.
oftentimes before the pivot line.
And you know what? I was also impressed with their ability to stay out of the penalty box and play a very clean roller derby game. I think that really caused some trouble for Boston last night. You know, and I think going into this, despite the number 10 seed going as number 5 seed, London may actually be going into this as the favorite, seeing that they handled Carolina much more easily than Montreal handled Carolina. Montreal was able to beat Carolina yesterday, but only after a 25-0 power jam, I believe, by Georgia W. Tush with about 3 minutes to go. And that finally got them their first lead in the game. So, you know, if the results kind of carry forward in the same way, you'd say London's got the edge here, but maybe Montreal's got something up their sleeve here.
Well,
it's
going
to
we'll
be really exciting to see.
If London is able to continue to make some waves coming from across the pond, or if Montreal tells them to take off, eh?
That's right. And so for Late Night Lyle, I am Kevin Up. Thank you guys for joining us. We're going to send you on over. We are going to keep on going.
We're
going to
keep talking for a little bit. No, it's Kevin, it's been a pleasure talking with you. This has been a fantastic tournament here in Baltimore, Maryland. Here at the Du Burns Arena. Want to remind everybody, if you've been watching the regular stream, you want to upgrade to the HD stream. Me and Kevin have it here, right here in front of us.
It's unbelievable.
Beautiful.
Professionally done. Unbelievable. It's going to look great on your HD screens at home, folks. We promise.
Really well. The first time, I believe, that any of the Big Five have been broadcast.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Blaze, by the Blaze Media, who's bringing us this one.
Okay.
Thank you very much. And so we're going to send you guys on over to Pelvis Costello, who's got an interview there. Interview the Boston's one of Boston's coaches there, Lil Payne. Take it away, Pelvis.
Thanks again, Late Night and Kevin Up. I am Pelvis Costello. I am here with Lil Payne, co-coach of the Boston Massacre.
Thanks for having me, Pelvis, and hello, Derby Nation. Much love.
We are totally excited that you're here, Little Payne. You guys went 3 bouts this weekend. Of course, we had you up against your storied rivals, Charm, your bout against London, and then coming in here, your victory, 213-90 against Dutchland. Coming down, flying here, what were the thoughts that you were trying to impart to your team members as they visualized that first bout?
Going into our Charm bout, which is sort of like a historic rivalry for us, we really tried to focus on thinking about our opposition as an opportunity to prove ourselves and demonstrate our fortitude personally and as a team. We really saw it as an opportunity to make ourselves known as deserving a place in the power rankings.
And I think that you did that. You definitely showed that completely. We talked to Kamikaze Kitten after your bout last night, and one of the biggest things that she said, she had paid the compliment, they had studied your games rather closely before coming in on that.
We had a feeling about that.
Yeah, and one of the biggest things that was said, because we said it was kind of like a Bizarro Superman type fight, where they seemed to definitely study it. And she had said that it's because Boston was one of London's heroes coming in on that.
That's wonderful.
And definitely we're seeing that coming into, you know, about 5. It is kind of cool to see sort of a Massacre stamp on that. Speaking of a Massacre stamp, we've noticed that the branding not only has changed, but there seems to be a definite strategy change as you're building up your new talent. Could you talk a little bit about that?
Roller derby is changing, in pretty dynamic ways. I think a lot of athletes who have played sports their whole lives are coming on board, and those skaters who are here from the beginning are really becoming amazing athletes themselves if they didn't start out that way, which many of them did. So we've really been trying to focus on becoming very strong and very fit and very communal, so that we don't have standout skaters, but that we all stand out together.
Well, this is definitely a case where we saw that the unit was working in full effect in this.
You said unit.
I did. I love that.
For those Sorry.
Of you taking it home. In the brackets currently we have you here, you definitely have earned your place right now where you're at seventh.
Yeah.
What we are seeing is going into the future, we're looking for this team. Obviously, it looks like you are building talent.
Trying.
What is your biggest takeaway for this in terms of strategy? Do you feel was working well? What do you think that you might want to improve on come the next time around?
I think it's very important for our team that we stay disciplined. Discipline makes things easier. I think that going into the next year, we're going to try and work more closely with teams like Maine, who we also played this weekend, to make sure that we have opportunities to really play as a team as much as possible. Because when we're on, we're really on. The trick for us is going to be on all of from whistle to whistle, so that when we play teams that are ranked above us, we have that fortitude that will really carry us through to a W.